Hey, it's James Murray. We're joined in the NetNews Ledger newsroom by Kenora Member of Parliament Bob Nault. Bob, Kenora got hit with rain a few weeks ago, and it's now Dryden's turn. What's happening on the level of flooding that you can tell our readers and viewers today?
Well, I think what we're starting to see is these freak storms that come up that are not just the usual rain that we're accustomed to over the years. Now they're like downpours, and our infrastructure system isn't built for, you know, fast 6 inches worth of rain all within a matter of hours, and I think that's what we're starting to see. I understand Dryden also got a significant amount of serious hail, so we'll see what kind of damage we have there. But again, this goes back to almost watching the same scenario that took place in Kenora a few weeks ago, where they had serious flooding, serious road damage, serious infrastructure overall damage. And so we're going to have to start looking at this from the perspective of developing climate change infrastructure that will put in place the abilities for us to be able to manage these kinds of scenarios when it rains or snows too much or hails, which all very much different than what we got in the past, as far as I can tell.
Now, what are you hearing from constituents in Dryden about how they've been hit by the storm?
Well, basically, I haven't had an opportunity at this stage to get an official update from Dryden. Hope to get that sometime today. Basically, been checking online to see what everybody's saying, and then, in essence, officially, everyone's being told to stay off the roads until this gets sorted out. And to add, more confusion to all this, Hydro One was supposed to have a shutdown to do some repairs today. So again, all that added up together makes for a long weekend for a lot of residents of the Dryden area.
I was in Dryden a few weeks ago, traveling through, and the power had been off all day. It just seems to never rain, but it storms, and that's the story in northwestern Ontario this summer.
Well, Northwest Ontario has had a pretty interesting summer so far, for sure, on the weather scene. You're either getting really hot weather, humid weather, then you go to these storms that just pop up. I was coming back. I was in Dryden when the power went off for about 4 hours and everything shut right down. I think it started around noon, didn't come back on until about 6:30. So that's not good for business. That's not good for, obviously, for homeowners, when it was a plus 30 that day. So there's been a lot of things going on. I understand Hydro's trying to get that sorted out, but there's been some transformer issues in the Dryden area with Hydro One. And then to add, as you say, insult to injury, it just seems that no sooner do we get something fixed and something else goes wrong. So it's been a tough summer for Dryden all the way around, and obviously the Northwest. But that gives us an opportunity to speak about what needs to be done to prepare ourselves for these kinds of occurrences vis-a-vis the weather patterns that we're starting to get. So that this will stimulate a good discussion this year on what we need to do with this new infrastructure initiative that we're proposing from as far as Canada and Ontario and municipalities are concerned. We've talked a lot about it. Now is to make sure that we do sewer, water, and upgrades to the region here.
Bob, if you hear things through the day, please get in touch with us and we'll share it with our readers.
All right, sounds good. Thanks for talking to you.